Okay, second hour in progress. Did a little mic adjustment. Hopefully it'll be a little bit louder without any of the heavy breathing. That was a bit of a complaint, or an observation, whichever. Flying buggy wants. Screeching devils. Great, so they draw more enemies. Obviously can't get over there yet. I'm playing it in story mode, so I don't know how much easier it could possibly be.
Not enough.
Do.
We are a unique species, brothers and sisters. We are not bred. We are not born. We come to life when we accept the gift of change. Our powers are many, and they have served us well. The art of glamour has given us safety through secrecy. But I am afraid we are becoming the victims of progress. Sooner or later, human technology will find a way to see past our illusions. They will expose and demonize us and make us their ultimate enemy. Inevitably, we will become their inferiors.
Well, you can't go out in the day, so you're already inferior, whether you believe it or not. Okay. Douche McTex-testicle.
Jesus, it's huge. When did they build this? And how?
It's nice not having to worry about ignition.
Looks even bigger up close. Well, let's crash their little party.
Guess who's come to dinner?
We consider ourselves proud hunters, predators. But that pride sometimes prevents us from growing as a species. Internal divisions have weakened us. Our numbers dwindle, while their numbers grow. But it's not too late. We can still survive, but to do so, we must be ready to adapt. We cannot be too proud to evolve.
Thank you.
We need to leave the shadows. Don't be fooled. Once our veil of secrecy is lifted, we won't stand a chance. We might be more powerful, but they will crush us with their numbers. Listen to the voice of reason. There is a thin line between being a survivor...
Enough. Your alliance thirst for all-out war with the humans endangers us all. Peter Navanum. Without the shield...
The wolves go hungry, yes. But the day is coming when the sheep will outwit the wolves. Haven't you been watching, brother? The humans have harnessed the power of steam and lightning, and they grow mighty. If our hubris allows us to grow fat and lazy in the shadows, they will soon have the power to hunt us down like dogs.
And so you propose war.
War suggests there is a chance we might lose. I propose we strike. With my new asset, we can control the change. Reclaim the Sanguisuja's rightful place at the top of the food chain.
Control the change. Are you mad? Even suggesting such a thing is blasphemy.
Dominic, brother, these are blasphemous times. While my methods may very well be at variance with our tradition, I can tell you one thing. If we don't adapt, we will perish.
Enough. I will not allow you and your bastard breed to lead us into annihilation. Peter Davala, for the high crime of conspiracy against your own kind, I sentence you and your line to the true death.
I told you, Father. They wouldn't listen.
We have to try, Felicity Mikara. Our work will be a lot easier if we can help them understand. If we can't...
Then... we... force them to!
Thank you. Think you could have brought a bigger knife?
Some people get a gold watch when they retire. I got Susan here.
Should have asked him how to get out of here.
Too late. He won't be of any use for a month or two. Wait. What about Chester?
Well, what are you gonna do?
Easier to carry than a whole body.
Now that is how you shape an explosion. Damn, we're late.
Now at least we won't be going back to the manor empty-handed. Spend taxpayers' money?
James Harrow. The people's hero. I heard the White House sends him golden toilet paper. Lungs he keeps the presidential ass clear of tick trouble. Feed him well. We've got a lot of ground to cover tonight.
You're not staying for the presentation? The whole institute is in town.
I'll pass on the corporate backpatting session. I don't need another retirement lecture. Here, take this to your father before it wakes up and starts cursing us all to high hell.
Great, so I'll just tell him you've traded killing vampires for swilling cheap bourbon?
Tell him whatever you want.
Fine, skip the presentation. But you ain't getting away from a final drink with me afterwards.
That's right, buddy. We got drinking to do. Okay, so there's literally no save.
Sweet home.
Jesse Rentier, you're a chip off the old block.
Yeah, who the fuck are you? Sir.
Good morning, sir.
Mr. Rentier?
At ease, boys. My father in his office?
He is. Hello, sir. Director Rentier spared no expense to improve those gauntlets.
How did it go? Did you get that big fangster you were after?
Sir.
Gravener's with you?
He sends his regards. He's afraid you'll try and talk him out of retirement again.
I don't believe either of us want that.
You know, he did risk his life to get this for you.
That's Harrow's trinket. I'm sure you'll both be rewarded accordingly.
Edgar isn't some civilian looking for a medal. This is all he knows. Your institute saw to that.
My institute? This isn't about Agent Gravener, Jesse. We are on the cusp of great progress. Great change. Today's presentation is of critical importance to the family. After which...
Edgar is family.
After which, I expect you to step up to your duties here at the manor.
With all due respect, Director, I am a field agent, not a paper pusher.
You're a rentier!
Why must you always make me spoon-feed these things to you, Jesse? There are bigger things at work here than running around in caves slaying beasts. I do believe someday soon you will see it my way. And if you don't, it's my responsibility to force that change. Now, leave me be. I must prepare for the presentation.
And send someone in here to clean up this mess.
A mess? To do shit yourself?
Mr. Rentier, Agent Feathers is waiting for you in the lobby.
Train fare here cost me an arm and a leg. Sure hope it's worth it.
Let's look around before we go see him. Anything this all worth huge. Fuck here?
Did you see that airship? All the big shots from D.C. don't come here for no reason.
Word is, heavy as hell. Version of the gauntlet, but I mean you didn't hear that from me.
Okay.
Edgar and my father in the Civil War, right before the bloody Battle of the Wilderness, Central Virginia. His life changed forever during that fight. Highborn nearly killed him. Badly tore up his leg. Edgar carried him in the dead of night across enemy lines to a field hospital, but the surgeon could only do so much. After that, Dad could no longer function in the field.
Director Rentier sure looks edgy. Something's up. I can smell it.
That's you. Take a shower, will you?
Mr. Rentier, you remember me?
No. I do not.
From my first year of cadet training, I'm the shortest one of the bunch. But the very next year, I grew like a weed. Had to buy all new pants.
Congratulations. We're all very happy for you.
Veil of Secrets.
Yeah.
Long time no see, Mr. Rentier.
Yeah, you shouldn't be bending over like that, buddy. It's really, don't present yourself like a fucking red-ass baboon.
You're just in time. The presentation should be starting soon.
What do you got for me this time?
Okay, I guess that's the one it wants me to get, or this. Ooh, I like having invulnerability. That's kind of handy. Where am I supposed to attend it?
Oh, officially they called it a cholera epidemic, but truth was they were dealing with a terrible outbreak of amateur necromancy. The entire institute was engaged in the hunt.
Okay.
As life goes on, we stand guard at the gates.
Again, I don't know where I'm supposed to go. Where is this big thing that's supposed to happen? Oh, here we go.
Seen Gravener by the stables. He ain't coming in.
I heard Gravener's finally retired.
Father in all his directorial glory. The artist who painted the portrait, what was his name? Philemon Cole? He was so curious about those gauntlets. Word came back that he talked about them in a local pub, and Father had to give him a very stern talking to. Scared the living piss out of him. Father was a very private person. I'm surprised he ever consented to even pose for this portrait. You can see by the look in his eyes, he wasn't too happy about it.
Yeah, well, he did it, so.
Good to see you back, sir.
Yeah, I don't know you.
Gentlemen, if you'll take your seats. And, welcome. Yeah, I'm Assistant Secretary of War, James Harrell. President Cleveland wants you to know how appreciative we are of the vital service the Urentia Institute performs, defending our great country from monsters of all shapes and sizes. He also wanted me to make sure you're not blowing all our money on Mexican Monty, but that's another conversation. Yes, quite. Well, as I say, keep up the good work. God bless you all, and God bless America.
Thank you all for gathering here tonight. It's rare we gather in such numbers, but I believe great progress calls for momentous celebration. Our efforts in the fight against the Sanguisuja's spread have too often been baffled by the creature's most insidious weapon, their so-called glamours. These impenetrable illusions have allowed countless fiends to slip through our grasp for too long. That ends now. Agent Rentier, we've upgraded the standard field agent's gauntlet with something our science bods have affectionately named the Zapper. Not exactly an elegant name, but it does the trick.
When triggered, the Zapper sends out an electrical impulse that shatters any nearby Sanguizu's glamours forthwith, eliminating what is not and leaving only what is.
Once finished, these new gauntlets will be distributed to cells nationwide post-haste, allowing us to sweep our respective territories for glamoured nooks and crannies. This is the beginning of a new age, gentlemen. Armed with this gauntlet, there is no way our enemy can surprise
us. Unless they fly a dirigible into our main facility.
Block. Okay. This looks neat. Okay. That looks fun. Let's do this. Okay. You have to use a timing thing. So okay. Didn't necessarily tell me where to do that, but okay. Okay, what do I have for perks? Projectile block, yeah, that would be handy. Huh. Okay, so these things aren't unlocked to me yet. So. I guess additional punches. Oh, I don't even have enough for that. Okay, so I literally can't buy anything yet. I don't have any of these available to me. I already have that one. And, okay, well fine. Why are you telling me about this shit then? Who the fuck cares? It says, you said I have perk points. Well, I don't. Get it. Why did you tell me I have these things? That's ignorant.
Jesus Christ. Hope Becker made it out in one piece.
To remember. Anything else here?
Left a Harrow Zeppelin. Maybe I could string a rope somewhere.
shit. Wow. Well, that's the first time. Okay, let's see how far back it puts me. Okay.
Far.
Jess, thank Christ.
Where's my father?
Still kicking ass last time I saw him.
Old fool thinks he's still in the field.
Listen, he wants us to destroy the archives before these assholes get their hands on it. You get to it and I'll find Harrow's pampered ass. Meet me out front.
Never thought I'd have to blow up my own house.
That's all right.
You're gonna be fine.
You okay, Agent? Just hold on.
No, I don't want that.
massacre. I'm gonna find who did this and tear them a new asshole.
I can zap to them. I can bring them to me, and I can go to them. That's pretty handy.
Ugly traps.
I can smell the gas. Joseph Warren and great-grandfather Dick. To find the Tick headquarters, he let the Brits take him captive. Would have loved to have seen the surprise on their faces when he incinerated those Tick nests and saved their royal asses. It's gonna blow.
How do I do that again?
gotta find my father.
Daddy, where are you, Daddy? Quake punch. Hold L1 and R1 to jump smash. Well, I mean, if you're gonna keep designating that I have to do these things, then what the fuck? Don't I get to pick? I guess not. Where my save point is, so this is about to end this recording, so I'm gonna call it and quit the game, and we'll see where it drops me next time I go to play, because it does not tell me where to save. Unsaved. It was 40 seconds since my last save, so that's not bad. All right. See you later.